Dear students, in my previous videos, I have taught you about the sources of Delhi Sultanate. In that sources, basically I have focused on literary sources and archaeological sources. Many literary sources I have discussed, and archaeological sources also, like Qutub Minar, and many tomb I have discussed, Adhai Din Ka Jhopra I have discussed, so many monuments, building I have discussed in my previous video. In this video, I would like to explain about Slave Dynasty. There were five successive rulers, ruling dynasty, namely, first one Slave, second one Khilji, third one Tughlaq, fourth one Sayyad, and last one Lodi. And Ibrahim Lodi was defeated by Babur in first battle of Panipat in 1526. One by one I'll teach about Slave Dynasty. The first three were the Turkish origin, and the Lodis were Afghan. Muhammad Ghori defeated Prithviraj Chauhan at the second battle of Tarain. I have taught in my previous video also, in 1192. And Delhi passed into the hand of these rulers later. From Delhi and Turkish rule was extended into the Gangetic plain and to Bihar and Bengal. The victorious Turks, before leaving for Afghanistan, left behind the slave General Qutubuddin Aibak as a viceroy of the conquered land. Qutubuddin Aibak founded Slave Dynasty. The early rulers of the Slave Dynasties are known as Mamluk. So I am going to tell you what do mean by the term Mamluk. Mamluk is an Arabic word, means owned, means purchased one, like tomato, potato, we are going to purchase. So that time it was a tradition that slaves were purchased by owner. So Qutubuddin Aibak, was purchased by Muhammad Ghori. So he was purchased one. Iltutmish was also purchased by Qutubuddin Aibak. So he was also slaves. So these sultans are known as Mamluk. Since the sultans were earlier either the slaves of the Turks or were the son of the slaves, they were called Mamluk Sultan. To complete his master's work, Qutubuddin Aibak embarked as a series of conquest and captured the Fort Kalinjar in Bundelkhand and Ahilwada, capital of Solankis in Gujarat. Qutubuddin Aibak laid the foundation of the Qutub Minar in Delhi after the name of his famous Sufi saint Khwaja Qutubuddin Bakhtiar Kaki, which was completed by Iltutmish in 1210. Aibak died of sudden fall from the horse at a Lahore while playing Chaugan or Polo. Dear students, you should understand that Qutubuddin Aibak reign and Babur reign are same. Babur also ruled 4 years. Qutubuddin Aibak also ruled 4 years. In between the 4 years, any ruler, can't do very much work. But whatever work Qutubuddin Aibak had done, I would like to teach you. So very brief, I would like to teach you. Qutubuddin Aibak had some special title also. He was known as Quran Khan. Means he had learned verse of the Quran, and orally he used to recites. So he was known as Quran Khan. And lakh bucks means he was very generous. He used to give many coins to the donors, to the needy people. So that's why historians told them lakh bucks. Means when he became happy, given money to needy people. So these important, okay, characteristics of the Qutbuddin Aibak, very competent ruler. But very soon he died. Aibak's son Aram Shah had succeeded him in 1211. Since Aram Shah was an incapable ruler, he was overthrown by Iltutmish, the slave and son-in-law of Alauddin Khilji. Iltutmish was the governor of Bihar at the time of his accession of the throne. Iltutmish successfully defeated his enemies. Iltutmish also quelled many other revolt and showed his political competency when he refused to give asylum to the Jalaluddin Mangbarni, the ruler of Iran. Jalaluddin had been driven out by Iran by Genghis Khan in 1221. Iltutmish rightly feared that if he give refuse to the enemy of Genghis Khan, the Mongols would invade India. Thus he saved the kingdom from the Mongol attack. Means when Mangbarni came to India and he requested for shelter, and Genghis Khan, he was the enemy of Genghis Khan, means Genghis Khan means Mongol, and Mongols were very furious one, means very brave soldiers, and if they will attack on India, to unnecessary Iltutmish will take face problem. So Iltutmish deny Mangbarni, means I don't like to help you, you go from India, leave India. Okay, now, so in 1929 Iltutmish received a deed of investiture from the Abbasi Caliph of Baghdad, a formal recognition of his independent position as a sultan. Another problem faced by Iltutmish was that many nobles did not accept him as a ruler because he was slave origin. To break their power, Iltutmish formed a governing class or nobility known as Turkane Chahalgani or Chalisa, a group of 40 people. Means one administrative body he made, in that body there were 40 members. So that group was known as Dale Chalisa or Turkane Chahalgani. He divided his empire into the numerous big and small iktas as assignment of land in lieu of salary. Means in place of salary, land given to iktidar. Iltutmish reign stand out of to be landmark in the medieval Indian currency system. He introduced two silver coins, Tanka and Jital. Tanka was made of silver, and Jital was made from copper. Two basic coins of the Sultanate period. Okay, so first time who introduced Iltutmish? Iltutmish had sons, but Iltutmish wanted that my daughter, his daughter Rajia, will be his successor. Iltutmish did not consider his sons are capable of becoming sultan. He therefore nominated his daughter Rajia as his successor, but many Turkish nobles opposed this move because they considered it below their dignity to be ruled by a woman. So they crowded Iltutmish's sons Rukunuddin, as they knew a new sultan. But within 7 months, Rukunuddin was removed from the throne and Rajia became the first woman ruler of Delhi Sultanate in 1236. In order to assert her claim, Rajia had to face tough resistance from her brother as well as the powerful Turkish nobles. These Turkish nobles called Group of 40 the Le Chalisa. Drunk with the power and arrogance, wanted to install on the throne a puppet whom they could control. They soon realized that through a human, Razia was not prepared to play their games. Razia was an able and brave ruler. She put to an end the chaos created by Rukunuddin and restored law and order. She dressed like a man and herself led to the armies in the battlefield. She gave up parda, held open court, listened to the problem of the her subjects, and exercised general supervision over the work of every department. Some provisional governors became hostile and rose against her. She tried to crush their revolt but could not succeed. She was defeated and imprisoned. Razia married Altunia also, the leader of the rebels, and tried to recover Delhi with the help, but both them were killed in 1240. So in this video only this much, and next video I would like to teach you two more video required, one for Khilji and one for Tughlaq. So only this much today. Thank you.